Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to today's workout. It is full body. We have two blocks of work today, and in each block there are 8 moves. Each move will be done for 40 seconds, and then we have 10 seconds of transition. There are 2 rounds in the block. So first one, I want you to just kind of get a feel for it, and then the second time you go through, give me some more intensity by upping the weight. Equipment today is dumbbells, a mat, and your body weight. You want to range it so that if you have one really heavy one, that can be a great one for doing some of the moves, and then lighter for some of the core arm movements. We got a lot of combination movements here. So if you're ready for this workout, make sure you give me a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you do not miss any workouts. All right, grab something really heavy. We're gonna do a double squat with an alternating knee up, kind of adding a little rotation to it so that you can use your core a little bit. So have your feet shoulder or wider, whatever feels good to you here. Weight is up in front of the chest. Eyes are lifted, here we go. Double squat, and then right knee comes up. Squat 2, and a little rotation there. You can get that core to really be activated here. And try to sink as low as you can in that squat. Press through the heels, keep the eyes lifted. And this is a great one to really go for some nice heavy weight here. You guys got some heavy weights on you? Somewhat. Hey, guess what though? It's a 2-rounder, so next round, add a little bit more to this. We got a few more seconds. Get ready for kickbacks and overhead extensions. We got 3 of each. 3, 2, 1. All right, grab something kind of moderate. Only have a few seconds, guys. Drop the chest. In 3 seconds, we're gonna go. And you're gonna kick back right now for 3. And then you're gonna stand up, swing the weight up. Overhead extension for 3. Bend the elbows, straighten them out. Long arms to bring them down. Elbows connect to your ribs. And then you kick back. Look out in front. Try to keep the arms straight when you're bringing them up and down. That kind of transition from the top to the bottom. That good kick back in. When you go up, you kind of use the legs to swing them up, softening the knees. Good job. 3 seconds, 2, lateral lunge. All right, I'm gonna grab just 1 weight here. And so as I lateral lunge, I'm gonna take my elbow to my thigh. Come back to center. So are you guys ready? Straight over the head. Lateral lunge. Step in. Yep, the first one you're gonna go, whoa. I gotta use that core. And then try to keep the weight over the head versus moving the arm so much. So if you don't touch your thigh, guess what? You'll be okay. Right, you can't talk really much when you're taking it into that side bend because you kind of hold your breath. Did you feel that there for you?
Yes.
Hold your breath, because you're bracing that core. 5 seconds. Big step out. And, all right, we got some squat curl here. So I'm gonna go a little heavier here. You're gonna squat, then you're gonna make curl and lunge. Ready? Let's go. Squat, then curl. Drop and switch. Good, so keep the legs moving. Really gonna add some arms here. So again, this should be moderate to heavy. If you have something heavy at home, keep your core bracing here, right? Have that feeling from those lateral lunges. Drop, pick it up, bring it to the shoulders. A lot of heavy breathing going on behind me here. Yeah. Little bounce down there. Big step to the back, 3 seconds. Inner thighs are coming up here. 1 dumbbell, I'm gonna go for 8. We're gonna add a little shoulder press. Right leg on the bottom. So you can stay here if you wanna make it easier. But we're gonna go with the hip up and add a little press as I swing that leg up to my opposite knee here. Inhale up, exhale down. Try to get the knee up to knee height of the opposite leg here. Oh yeah. And your stabilizer is your core and your other arm. Oh yes, everything we do this side, we're gonna do it on the other side. Good, come on, get that leg up. You can have that heel kind of in, toe turning out. Oh yes, 3 seconds.
All right, switch it around. Oh, y'all, they are seriously breathing heavy here. Woo! So, here we go. Everything is up. A little shoulder press and a little adduction here, swinging upward. Boom, right? Inhale, exhale. Oh, yeah. And then that bottom arm, right, is pushing the ground away. Your shoulder stays away from the ear. Inhale again. Exhale even more. And there's a breeze from the exhale behind me. Come on. 5 seconds. Focus here. You got this. Pullover is going to come next. 3, 2, and 1. Grab a one-headed dumbbell or 2 dumbbells. Lie on your back. Legs are up. I take the weight behind the head. Here we go. And then bring it up. So in a pull over, the arms stay long with a slight bend in the elbows. Go back, 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 back as far as you can. Your dumbbells touch the ground and you've gone far enough, right? Inhale, away. Exhale up. You can even do 1 dumbbell with the hands kind of in that triangle position. I like it. I like to change it. Right? Lower down the legs if you'd like to add more intensity, or just keep them up. So you really want to focus on the lat. It's the bottom part of this movement that feels it. Right, that's that right underneath the bra. Here we go, we're coming on up. Woo, calf raises. Grab 1 dumbbell. I'm gonna grab a 10. Let's go on the right foot first. So we're just lifting that heel up. So if your balance is a little off, your toe on the other foot is just gonna help you. Lift all the way up on that. Toes, right, dig them into the ground. And then halfway, we're gonna step into a lunge and lift the heel up. All right, so step back. And from here, lift the heel, lower the heel. All right? And get a little low. You can lean a little bit into that front leg. So we work a different part. We work soleus and then gastrocnemius here. So we do it with the leg straight, and then we do it with the knee bent. 3, 2, 1. All right, we're gonna start from the top. We'll finish the other foot next round here. You have 30 seconds, so this is a great time to get some water, towel off if you need to. I think I forgot everything of my stuff here, so that'll be okay. I'll survive. I like to always make sure I drink a lot of water first thing in the morning, right? Then right after my workout, I'm drinking tons of water. All right, we got about 5 seconds here. Double squat, get ready to go. Is ready? Let's start with this left leg first. Squat, squat, left knee up. Now, we go intensity second round, right? Maybe it's a quicker bounce, down, down. Almost like you're gonna jump off the floor. Maybe you do a little hop, down. Who's hopping a little bit? Depends on. All right. Sumo squat, that's totally great too. Even the knee comes up faster. Boom, right? Get low in that squat if you can. You got 3 seconds. And drop it. Here we go, kickbacks. 3 of them, and then 3 overhead extensions. Oh, drop that chest, elbows in, 3 kickbacks. Swing the arms up, overhead extension. Soften the knees, chin up. Straight arms coming down, elbows pull in. Get your elbows cranked up by your ribs here. Use your glutes when you're swinging that weight up. Control it. Right, you're bringing it up, you're bringing it down. You should be feeling your core working. Most of these moves are really gonna use that core today. 3 seconds, add a lunge. Right, pick a weight. Remember how that core has to activate. Let me step it out. We're gonna step to the side first here. Weight is up over the head, lateral, and touch. Good, big step out. It can even be a little bit behind you, that step. Oh yeah. Got a brace, and then push off, right? So I think you're gonna sneeze there. All right, lateral.
Woo. I can't wait to see what I look like.
Yeah, big step. Push off that foot. Use some power. You got 5 seconds, you guys. And then we're gonna go into that inner thigh movement with the shoulder press. All right, we're gonna go for a squat with an alternating lunge back. Roll the shoulders back. So we're gonna start with that squat first. Here we go, squat down, whoops, sorry, squat, and then lunge it down here. So eyes stay up. All right, drop in the squat and then lift up. Bring that fist to your shoulder. Keep your core braced. That core's really working hard right now.
Yeah.
That's gonna give you great support, especially in your low back. And again, how low can you go in those squats? Maybe you feel like you're picking something off the floor here. Chest is up. Oh yes. Stay low if you can. 3 seconds, two, and one. Nice job. Woo. I'm gonna keep the 10. Right leg on the bottom. You know the move now. Everything is up. Here we go. So what can make this harder? Maybe the leg swings a little bit further in front of you. It's further away from the body. That's gonna be a little harder, you guys. Go heavier in the weight on the arm. Oh yeah. Starting to feel it the second time even more. So, you know, I do know you guys love no repeats, but sometimes repeating something is just gonna give you a little bit more of that intensity, and that's when we can have more change. Right? 3 seconds. Two. All right, you guys, let's switch it around. Nice job. Did you go further away with the leg?
Yeah.
Did you do something to make it more challenging? All right, we are up. Here we go. So again, that leg can swing a little bit further in front. Kind of liking this combo. Right, a little shoulder, inner thighs, abs, oh yes. Not that we do this kind of movement in life, but whew, you never know. 10 seconds, ooh, the sweat's coming down my back now. Ooh. Pullover's coming up next, 3 seconds, two, and one. All right, grab something heavy, I'm going one heavy dumbbell. You got it? Let's go, guys. Whew, weight is up. Lower it down as far as you can go, and then bring it up to the top over the chest. You only need to go up as high as chest. Lower, lower, lower. When you get to the bottom of the range here, can you pause for a moment? And then bring it up. And if you feel like it's just too easy, you know what I'm gonna say. A little heavier, right? Lower down, pausing, and bring it up just to the chest again. Come on, leg addition if you want to or not. 3 seconds. All right, we are up. Calf raises, other leg. One dumbbell, this is it, you guys. End of this round. Here we go. Standing, go ahead and lift. All right, lift that heel up. You know, if you're next to something like a chair, you could use your friend, ooh, or your counter. Ooh, I just got really hot there. So is that, yeah, just like, ooh, feeling it. We're having like this amazing, beautiful day here. All right, bend the knee, okay? Lift the heel, lower the heel. Go for some speed maybe. So again, hitting different angles of the calf. Shoulders back, chest is up, lift and lower, 3 seconds, two, and one. All right, great time for you to get some water again. This is the end of round one. So towel off, get your water, whatever you need. Whew. All right, you guys, we're moving on to block two. We have a single arm snatch. I'm gonna go really heavy here, and we're gonna alternate it. So I lift it up, drop it down, and then I do the other arm. So this is where you really want a nice heavy weight. Yep, go for, you should have the 20.
I don't know where the other one was.
It's in the garage. Okay, So get ready to pick it up. Eyes up, here we go. Snatch it up, place it down and switch. So stay low, right, when you get down into the bottom and just change the hands. And when you bring that weight up, remember a snatch is where we, or clean and press, whatever you want to call it. It stays close to the body. If you have a really light weight, you could just do a nice big straight arm swing. That would be another option here. But this is great cardio, great full body. And again, this should be a nice heavy weight. Like even myself, I could have gone a little heavier. But then you go, wow, that's a really big dumbbell, right? So all four, rainbows. We're gonna move our right leg first. When I take it out to the side, heel goes down. Right, when I take it back, toe goes back. Here we go. Heel and toe. Come to the side, heel, then toe back. If you wanna come on your elbows, you can. Try to make it a nice range, up and over, up and out. Well, if I get, you know, if you feel like it is awkward, do what you need to do, right? But it just takes it mindfulness, right? So you're not thinking of something else like, what am I gonna eat, right? You're gonna think about, ooh, let's go for some intensity here. Each leg gets 40 seconds. You got 3 seconds here. Two and one. Huh. Woo. All right, other side. Remember, add that rotation in your leg if you can. You need to come on your elbows, you can. Leg is up, heel to the front, toe to the back. And again, core, right? It's gonna be your supporter here. It's gonna help control the movement. Up in front. Keep it braced. Good for your digestive system, right? Getting some rotation in there. On heel down, toe back, 10 seconds. Kind of push back in those hands so you keep the weight in your legs here. 3, 2, C curl, seated. I'm gonna be using, so like 5 or 8s are good for you. I'm gonna turn my feet this direction. So come into a rounded back, and you're just gonna give me some little bicep curls. Chest is open, and then the option is, feet come off the floor, right? And just hold. So again, we wanna feel like it is a challenging weight, not too light. Everybody's good with their weight. There you go. Yes, we do get 2 rounds, so pay attention. That's where you wanna be thinking about, like, did they feel like it was enough? All right, you guys, you got 5 seconds. Then we have a V up. Still using the weights in our arms here. Relax. So here's the V up. Arms are gonna be kind of out in a T. Then you're gonna tuck in here. Out in a T. Then tuck in, ready? Here we go. You're out, you're in. Extend and bend. Arms have a softness in the elbows, right? And you know, if you feel like you need to do something else with your arms, you can do that. You can almost do like a chest fly, right? Bring them in front. So great ways to just work with what you have. I like a little fly action. How about you? Oh yes. What kind of action do you got here? Down and up. 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Whew. All right, we got a crisscross. This crisscross, right? We're gonna stay here. Thumbs are gonna be up, right? If you wanna crisscross, drop it down. Here we go, thumbs are up, cross, cross. Again, thumbs can be up. If you want no weight, no weight, but the chest is lifted here. Isometric hold in those arms. Open, close, come on. Oh yeah. Tuck your tailbone a little bit here. Woo, your arms get too much. You can let them go. Ooh, I was gonna do something else there. Oh, you want palms up here, last few seconds. Right, you can bend your elbows, bring the weight a little closer to you. Right, it's getting kind of heavy. I'm gonna bend my elbows 3 seconds, 2, and relax. All right, try to keep what you've got. Flip it onto your hands and toes. We got a reverse fly in plank position or on your knees. Ready, set, here we go. You're gonna fly. So you open it up with a softness in the elbow. Push down on the dumbbell that's on the ground. Right, a fly is the opposite of like that chest fly, right? We call it a rear delt fly. You can call it this thing. Right, I always like it when people see me, they're like, you know, I was doing this one thing, it looked like this. That's okay, you don't need to know the name, as long as you're doing what you can. Keep your hips shining down, shoulders and hips. Again, if you need the knees to the ground, you got 4 seconds. Whew. And relax. Everybody's waiting. We're waiting. Come to your forearms. Come to your forearms. Turn to the front. Drop your hip down, up. Boom, boom. Turn down. And then turn to the back. Drop the hip down, up. So we're rotating in that forearm plank, adding a hip dip. Okay, so make sure you have room to move. Drop it. And your shoulders are getting a lot of work here too. Hold for a moment in that forearm plank and then turn your body. Great job. Woo. Really push that hip up when you go up, right? Turn it. Great job. All right, here we go. That was it. So we're at the bottom now. So we're gonna start everything from the top. So if you're ready to get a sip of water, towel off if you need to. I think I'm okay. How about you? Whew. Everybody's good? Yeah. All right. Single arm snatch. We're gonna go in about 10 seconds. Yeah. Do you have a 15? One plus 15? There you go. Let's start with this arm here. Okay. Ready and set. Here we go. Pick it up, snatch, and the knees to drop it. Don't drop it by just dropping it to the ground. Right, you bring it down to the ground, it should be like a quiet drop. Shouldn't be loud. You don't hear anybody else's dumbbell back here. Bring it all the way up. That means you gotta bend those knees to get to that ground. And if you need to open the legs up wider, open them up a little wider. Last few seconds, can you go a little faster? Boom. From the bottom, push to the top. 4, 3, 2, 1. All four, here we go. Here's that rainbow, right? Here's that rainbow, right leg. On your hands and knees, lift that leg back. Here we go, heel, take it, rotate, toe. And try to make that movement, even when you come forward, 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 as big as you can, right? How far forward can you go? Yeah, just don't hit your friend, right? Those long legs. Woo! This kind of works all angles in your hips and your thighs here. Get that leg as far forward as you can. Come on, come on, come on. 3 seconds. Nice job. Oh, good job.
I feel like I'm holding my breath a lot.
Yeah, we are holding our breath because we're using the core. Here we go. Other side, leg is up. Bring that heel forward and toe back. Big movement up and over, right? Like a rainbow, right? And again, bring it forward as much as you can. And try different things where maybe you're on one elbow or two. Just see what feels better for you. Kind of one is good. Woo! Oh yeah. Got 8 seconds here. Then we got that C curve with those curls. So if the first time was too heavy, or too light. All right, here we go. I'm gonna turn the other direction here. C curl. Get ready. On your back, roll shoulders back, sink here, right, and then from there, just a little bit of a bicep curl. You can have the feet up, or the feet can be down. It could be, you know, one leg, but don't get too fancy, right? Because then all of a sudden you're like, I don't remember what I was doing here. Keep your wrists straight, brace the core, pull up and in that core. Remember, you can just even put your feet down. If your back is an issue, put a pillow behind you. Right, or a little squishy ball would work also. Oh yeah. All right, here we go, relax. V up. If you wanna make it different this time, start with everything off the floor and the arms reach back and then bring the arms forward. You could do almost like that pullover. So here we are, we're all the way extended and then all the way up. Inhale, down, hold, exhale, up. It could be one dumbbell. All right, your core will be so braced. It's gonna give you such good posture when you're done with this workout, right? We didn't do a single sit-up, right? Extend and hold, and bring it up, nice job. You're gonna work your lats again, right? We like those lats. 5 seconds. Woo! Then we have crisscross. All right, nice job. Whew. Yes, crisscross. All right, so if you're feeling like this is too much, bend your elbows. Legs are extended, crisscross. You wanna drop that low back. Right, I can have the arms right here, holding here, open, close. You can go bigger on the crisscross. You can add a little pumping of the arms. Oh yes, lots of things going on here. Or just hold it, so you can even be more upright. Woo. Use those inner thighs, right? One goes over the other. Ooh, 5 seconds. Then we're gonna go to that reverse fly here. Woo. You stopped there, Carol. Oh, then you know it was getting tough, right? We're gonna go to that fly. Come into your plank position here. Woo. Here we go. Open that arm out to the side and switch. Keep your hips shining down. Okay, so open up your feet. That's a wide base there. Here's that option, right? You can always drop the knee. You're gonna still use the core. Oh yes. Push down in the hand that's on the ground as you open the other arm out. Look out in front. Hips just below the shoulders. There we are. Woo, 3 seconds, two, and relax. Here's that forearm plank, you guys. Adding that rotation. All right, so we come to the forearms at this point. You're down there. Rotate to the front. Down up at the hip. Rotate to the back. Woo. No need to rush here. So even the holding for just that split second, it's gonna give you some more of that intensity. Yeah. Oh yes. Don't fall on me. Okay. Get a little twister here. Through. Woo. This is it. This is our last movement. Yeah. And nice job. All right. Give me a nice child pose. We'll sit back into your heels. Woo. And I don't know if you noticed, we have Sparky in the back here. I tried to put him in the house, but he just didn't want to go. He's like, if you guys are going to be out here, I'm going to be out here. All right, when you're ready to, nice straddle stretch. So walk those hands back. I'm just going to stop my timer so you don't have to listen to this thing go off. Oh, nice straddle. Oh, we kept it kind of short today so you could get it in, get it out. Ooh. Oh, walk those feet in. Roll yourself up. Go ahead and face forward. Bring that right arm across the body. Drop the chest. Or drop the chest. Drop the shoulder. Keep your eyes lifted. Brace the core. And then pat your back. Oh, open up through the front. Woo. Little side bend. That feels good. And release it. Let's do the other arm. Bring it across the body. Drop the shoulder. Take a deep breath. Yeah, great job here. Pat your back. You did awesome. Push that elbow back. Chin is up. And then when you're ready, do a little side stretch there. Because that core was braced the entire time, right?
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah. All right, reach it out. Reach it up. Reach it back. And then bring it down to your heart center. that, my friend, is it. Great job today. Woo! Good for you. Thank you, guys. How do you feel?
Oh, great.
Woo. That was awesome, you guys. You have an awesome day. We'll see you again soon. Take care.